Hello, my name is José Marcos Ortega. I'm a professor of the Civil Engineering Department at the University of Alicante in Spain, and I will continue with the video tutorials related to the online teaching of the subject, the Structures 3 of the degree in Fundamentals of Architecture, given here at University of Alicante. I'm going to continue with the videos related to the sessions 8 and 9 of practical classes of the subject related to the design of reinforcement in beams. And now in this tutorial we are going to continue with the design of the longitudinal reinforcement of this exercise. In the last tutorial, in the last video, I finished here. We have calculated the minimum amount of reinforcement that, or the minimum area of tension reinforcement that must arrive to the supports in a beam. We have calculated the minimum for the streams supports and for the intermediate supports. And finally, we must, the only thing that left is to check that if we accomplish that. As we show in a picture in this step, we have this proposal of solution for longitudinal reinforcement in the beam. And then here, in this support, the tension reinforcement which arrives is 2 bars of 16. Here, the tension reinforcement that we have is 2 bars of 16 plus 2 bars of 20, because here we have negative bending moment. And here, the tension reinforcement in this part C, or in this extreme or support C, is 2 bars of 16. Then, the minimum reinforcement that must arrive to the supports was this one, the intermediate, and this one for the stream, and this one for the intermediate, and directly the base reinforcement of 2 bars of 16 with a mechanical capacity of 174.8 kilonewtons already accomplished this minimum of reinforcement in the supports. Then the solution is valid regarding that. I told you that in intermediate support we have 2 bars of 16 plus 2 bars of 20, then which more reason to accomplish that. Then, once finished this, the solution, the proposal of longitudinal reinforcement shows or seems to be valid until now. And then the thing that we must do now is to calculate if we come back to the picture of this page, now we are going to calculate from one point to one point of the beam, and we must arrange this additional reinforcement. Okay, for the positive additional reinforcement and for the negative additional reinforcement. When from one point to one point, we must arrange it. And is the next steps. The next step is we come back to the point. We are in the page 11 of the solution. Is this point or this step C.5 is to calculate the longitudinal reinforcement with all the distances, measures, and the position from which to which it goes the additional reinforcement of negative and positive bending moments. And the first step is to calculate the maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement. For this, we are going to use this expression, which is in this document, in document tema or unit 225, when we have the equations for designing a rectangular cross section subject to pure bending, and we have the formulas to check rectangular section subject to pure bending. We are going to this this expression. Okay, this expression is for calculating or for to check cross section when we know the reinforcement that we have without considering the contribution of compressed reinforcement. Here, for the base reinforcement, we are not going to consider this contribution of compressed reinforcement because, as you told, in that the compressed reinforcement is the minimum that we arrange, because when we calculate it, even for the maximum positive and the maximum negative bending moment, we calculate the mechanical capacity required. In both cases, we are in case one, and the US2, the mechanical capacity of compressed reinforcement, was equal to zero. Then the compressed reinforcement that we have is the minimum. Then we are going not to consider the contribution of this minimum to the maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement. And then, for that case, the expression to use is this. This is the maximum bending moment, MRD or MU, ultimate bending moment, that can support the cross-section with a determined reinforcement is equal to US1, the mechanical capacity of the tension reinforcement, multiplied by 1 minus US1, mechanical capacity again of tension reinforcement, divided to 2, multiplied by U0. U0 is the U0 that we always use, okay, in the subject, and multiplied by the D, which is the effective depth. And this is accomplished always, always that is also verified that US1 is not higher than 0.5 multiply U0. Then so we are going to apply this to obtain the maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement. When we have a bending moment higher than this maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement, then in that parts we will arrange the additional reinforcement for negative or for positive bending moments, depending on the case. So if we come back to the solution, we are here is the same expression, and then we are going to calculate the ultimate or the maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement, the 2 bar shock system, with this expression. This expression, here is a note. The note is for if we want to apply this expression for calculating MU, the ultimate bending moment that can support the base reinforcement, here we have used the criterion of the moment frontera or bordered moment, okay, the criterion of the 0.295 U0. Then in this case, this condition that I told you or that I explained in the document 225, this condition of US1 must be not higher than 0.5 U0, if we use the criterion of the moment border or moment frontera, the 0.5 is changed by 0.36, is the only difference, but it's easy. Here is indicated if we has used the criterion of the limit moment equal to 0.375 U0D, it must be accomplished that US1 is not higher than 0.5 U0, which is the thing that it is set in this document 225. Yes, then we are going to check this in our case, the US1 of the base reinforcement, the 2 bar shock system. If we come back to this table, tension reinforcement 2 bar shock system is 175.8 kilonewtons. So we have it here, and 0.36 U0, we have calculated in the steps C1 and C2. It has not changed. It was equal to 2,352 kilonewtons. Then 0.36 multiplied by U0 is equal to 846.7 kilonewtons. Then it is accomplished that US1 is not higher than 0.36 U0, is lower, okay? It's very, very lower. Very, very low compared to this 0.36 U0. And then we can go to this expression, U0, no changes. US1 for 2 bar shock system is also shown previously, has also been shown. And the effective depth was also calculated in other steps, and it was equal to 0.336 meters. And then we replace the parameter, each parameter, by its value here, and we arrive to this, the ultimate or the maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement is that US1, 174.8 kilonewtons, multiplied by 1, minus US1 again, 2U0, multiplied by D. And the value for this maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement of 2 bar shock system without additional reinforcement is 56.6 kilonewtons by meter. And now, when we know that, we are going to calculate the points, these points, the points, I show you again the diagram, this picture, we are going to calculate these points strictly. And after we have it, we must to increase the length of the additional reinforcement by the anchorage lengths. Now, for obtaining these points, once we know the maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement, we are going to use the equations of the bending moments law, of the bending moments law for the different parts of the beam. This expression, I remind you that we have calculated. I have given you in the first page of the first page of the solution, and we give you first the expression, and we calculate the parameters, the FED we have calculated again, and more or less we have it completely. And now we come back here, we take the bending moments equation for the part ED, which was this one, 5 divided 16 multiplied by FED multiplied by X. FED, remind you, that was 114 kilonewtons, is in the page 1 of the solution calculated. And this is the final expression. And in the part ED, we have only positive, okay, bending moments. And then we make this, we make the following. This equation for the bending moments law for the bending moments equation for the part ED is equal to the positive value of the ultimate or the maximum bending moment that can support the base reinforcement, the 56.6, and we obtain the value from the point A. This X, I remind you that the origin of X is the extreme, the left extreme or the left support of the beam, the point A. Then, if we come back here to this calculation, we obtain that the additional reinforcement for positive bending moments starts in this point, okay, in the point 1.59 from the extreme A. From this point, the base reinforcement cannot support the bending moments, so we need to arrange this additional positive reinforcement. And for the part DB, the bending moments equation was this one. Here we replace FED by its value, 140, and the bay length L by 5.8 meters, which is its value. And operating, we obtain finally that the equation of the bending moments law for the part DB, D is the midpoint, okay, of the bay, and B is the intermediate support, is this expression. And here, if we come back to the diagram, here we have a positive part of bending moments and a negative part of bending moments in this part DB. We have a part with positive bending moments and a part with negatives. Then we obtain here the final point of the additional reinforcement for positive moments, and here the initial point of the additional reinforcement for negative bending moments. We come back to the corresponding page 12, I think we have, is the thing that we are going to do here. We make for finding the finish point of the additional reinforcement for positive bending moments, we make this equation equal to the positive value of the ultimate bending moment that can support the base reinforcement. And this equation here, and then the maximum in positive value bending moment that can support the base reinforcement. And then this is equal to X equal to 3.5 meters. Then the final point of the final point of the positive additional reinforcement will be 3.5 meters from the extreme A. And for the negative bending moments, we take the equation, and this equation will be equal to the minus